If you are an IT project manager, you must follow these AI trends. Because what I'm seeing right now is that people are waiting for a perfect AI project management tool, but it will not come anytime soon. And if you delay your mastering of these AI tools, you will fall behind your competition as quickly as these AI tools develop. That's why trend number one is more like a mindset that you need to accept. Because AI tools will be developed for specific use cases. Rather than waiting for a perfect, full end-to-end project management tool with AI capabilities, you need to understand that AI tools will solve narrow problems. That's exactly why it's critical that you play around with these tools to understand how to integrate them into your project management approach. But what's even more important, you need to master one critical skill. And I'm talking about project tailoring skill, because you will input or integrate AI tools to solve narrow problems inside one of the steps in your project management approach. That's exactly why I created the Power of Project Tailoring workshop. It's totally free and will cover the most essential things that you need to master project tailoring skills, because that's the most important skill that a project manager will need in 2025. And we'll discuss things like what factors will impact project management in general, what you need to think about when you build your project management approach and when you run your projects. All you need to do is to find the link below this video, go to this page and click here to register. It's totally free. Just enter your email address and your name and reserve your spot today. All right, let's move on to trend number two, because I'm super excited about it. I'm already seeing how different AI tools get the capability to see and analyze your screen. And right now you can already test it with Gemini 2.0 version. And you can think about a very obvious use case. You can create a lot of drafts of user stories by showing AI your screen and sharing your wireframes or designs. The cool thing is that you can already test out these capabilities. If you search for Google AI Studio, you'll find it here. And if you go to stream real time, you can test it out. And do notice that you can output the AI's results into audio or text. If I were to do it real life example, I would choose text so that I can easily copy it and paste it into Jira, for example, but for this demo, I'll use audio. I will share the login page on my website to create user stories for our own development. Can you see my screen?
Yes, I can see your screen. It shows the login page for ITPM School. Is there anything else I can help with?
I have the following page on my product as well. I would like you to create 5 user story titles for my software development team.
Sure, I can help with that. You want 5 user story titles for your software development team based on the login page you're showing. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, here are 5 user story titles based on the IEM School login page. 1. As a user, I want to log in with my email and password so I can access my account. 2. As a user, I want to see a clear email field so I can enter my email address. 3. As a user, I want to see a clear password field so I can enter my password. 4. As a user, I want a login button so I can submit my credentials. 5. As a user, I want a forgot your password link so I can reset my password if I forget it. Do those sound like good user stories for your team?
Yeah, these are good user stories. Can you please write out the user story for email field with all possible verification rules?
All right, I can do that. Here's the user story for the email field with possible verification rules. As a user, I want the email field to validate my input to ensure it is a correctly formatted email address before allowing me to submit the login form. This includes requiring the presence of an @ symbol. Requiring at least 1 character before and after the @ symbol. Requiring a after the @ symbol. Preventing blank spaces. Providing clear error messages if validation fails. Does that capture all the necessary verification rules?
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
No, that's all. I hope you can see the power of this tool now. All right, let's move on to trend number 3. And it's also an exciting opportunity for project managers who lead small projects where they combine the role of a project manager and a business analyst. And I'm talking about browser AI agents. The agents that will be able to use your own browser to get through websites and collect the required information or take the required actions. Unfortunately, right now, I have seen only betas and alphas of these browser agents, and there's nothing you can really play with to solve a complex problem. But I believe it will be a big thing this year, and you should definitely keep track of it if you are spending a lot of time on business analysis. Because think about a use case. You can list all the competitors that have a similar software product as you have, and you ask AI to go and do the competitor analysis. You will find the best features that they have, UI solutions that they applied, and you will use this competitor analysis to develop a better version of the requirements for your own product. And this leads us directly to the trend number 4, which is AI agents. And if you follow this AI domain right now, this is the word that's on everyone's mouth. You can think about AI agents as the combination of AI tools and some other tools. So for example, I can see a use case where you have your Jira and a developer closes a task. So you will have an AI agent sitting there and it will try to collect all the performance data. It will try to derive all the required metrics from the information that was provided, or it will go and Slack a team member to provide or correct the data inside the ticket. And because this agent will have this AI capability, it will be able to find a solution to derive the required data. Instead, if you think about a typical automation in Jira, it's very limited to specific automations and rules that you set up. So in general, I recommend that you keep an eye on all the AI agents that come up in this year, because I'm pretty sure that there will be project management specific dedicated agents inside each and every tool. And again, just based on these trends and these use cases, I want you to understand one critical thing, that there will not be an AI solution that will take over the whole workflow or section of your project management. Instead, AI tools, agents, or whatever will be sitting in one spot, doing some routine or tedious tasks that you don't like, that takes too much time to do it manually. And that's exactly why all project managers in 2025 will have to develop expert-level tailoring skills. They should know and understand how to tailor the old Jira with its tickets to the new AI agent that appeared yesterday. But what's even more important, after you processed the data with some AI agent, you also need to understand how to benefit from the data and new capabilities that you got in the next step in the project management process. And again, if we look at the same use case with Jira and performance data, you must understand how you will use this data further. Maybe you will put it into the progress reports. And by the way, that might be a different AI tool that will specifically create the required slide decks with this data. Or you will run a different agent to assess risks based on the ongoing live data that comes from your team. All that requires tailoring, understanding of each separate piece, its benefits, and how it integrates into one system, into one workflow. Again, that's exactly why I developed the Power of Project Tailoring workshop, where I will specify all these nuances and the mistakes that people make in project management. So register today. The link is below this video. This leads us to the next trend. And again, I think it's a kind of a mindset, or even better, it's a new skill that you need to develop. You need to understand that in the following years, the human in the loop will be a critical skill to have. Again, you can imagine that you will have some separate AI agents dedicated to project management. They will know more about project management rather than general information like ChatGPT. And they will provide you the outputs of their work to get your feedback, approval, or validation. And you will be giving them this approval so that the next step or the next AI tool can proceed. And let me tell you this. Ability to analyze and adjust AI tools and the prompts that you give them is a critical skill. It's a new skill that everyone should master. There won't be out-of-the-box solutions that will fit directly into your project management approach. They all will require some testing, adjustments, and customization to your needs. And you won't develop all those skills just overnight when these project management tools appear in your organization. That's why it's critical that you start mastering these interactions, customizations, and improvements of existing AI tools today. This leads us to an advanced trend that is happening right now, but it's only for those project managers with ambitions to lead this AI transformation in the project management domain. And I'm talking about using the automation tools to build your own kind of first level, first draft AI agents. Things like Zapier or Make.com allows you to combine AI tools with other tools that you use for project management. For example, one agent that you can build yourself in about 60 minutes if you have zero experience with these tools is like this. Imagine that after each meeting, you get a transcription of this meeting. And if you put it into a specific Google Drive folder, then the automation kicks in. And it will use ChatGPT API to get the summary and action items on the list, on this transcription. Then the output of the summary will go into a dedicated Slack channel. You can also think about a further step where you will take the action items and automatically create tasks for yourself inside your project management tool. Just imagine how much time it will save you if you need to send follow-up meeting notes for all the meetings each day. I encourage you to explore these trends yourself over the next few months to see which ones will actually happen. But I hope that you see the thread across all these AI trends that relates to you as a project manager. You will be the one who needs to decide where to put these AI capabilities inside your project management approach. And again, you will not get a PM tool that will cover the whole project management approach. You will have to find a creative way to tailor in these tools into the existing approach, into the policies of your organization, and the way you work. That's exactly why I want to remind you about the workshop that is happening very, very soon, depending on when you watch this. So I want you to go to this page and register today. Just click here to register, enter your first name and email address, and I'll see you live on the workshop. This will be the most important training for you this year. And the best thing about it, that it's totally free. But if you are wondering how does a tailored project management approach looks like, I recommend that you watch this video next. It will show you the big picture of project management as you should implement it in the real world. Click the video now and I'll talk to you there.